Ahead, this is pretty remarkable. Researchers believe they may have just discovered the one-size-fits-all key to killing cancer. And get this, they discovered it by accident.
We found a new type of white blood cell that has the capacity to kill most cancers from all people.
Is a new discovery the one-size-fits-all cure for cancer? I mean, researchers there in the UK believe maybe. Joining me now via Skype is Dr. Melissa Johnson. She is a medical oncologist and the associate director of lung cancer research at the Sarah Cannon Research Institute in Nashville. Doctor, thanks for being with me, because this was stunning. And I just want to play a little bit more of that sound. They explain how they found this and how it works. Take a listen.
And we've taken the molecule off the surface of that cell and genetically engineered it into patient T cells in the laboratory and shown in the laboratory that they can now kill the patient's cancer while ignoring healthy cells. The reason we're really excited about this approach is because of the capacity to be a universal therapy.
And that is what is remarkable, in addition to the fact that they discovered it by accident. Do you think this is the cure for cancer?
This research is important because it advances our current knowledge about specific interactions between a patient's immune system, a patient's white blood cells, and a growing cancer. The reason that it's important is because it supports other research that suggests that we could teach our immune system, we could teach our white blood cells to identify cancer, to attack it, and get rid of it.
1.8 million people are diagnosed with cancer every single year. 600,000 people die. I don't know anyone that hasn't been affected by cancer. So for them to hear the possibility that this could be the answer, it is remarkable, but it hasn't been tested on humans. So how long before it would be tested and then possibly implemented?
You're right. The reason that immunotherapy, and that's what this is, by the way, a type of anti-cancer treatment that boosts our own immune system called immunotherapy. The reason this is so important is because it relies on each patient's unique immune system rather than targeting something that's particular for a breast cancer or a lung cancer.
That's what I found so interesting, that this particular cell treats a variety of cancers. You would assume that each lung, breast, any kind of cancer would process differently in the body. Is that not true?
Well, it's true, but the breakthrough that is immunotherapy is that it doesn't matter what the cancer cells looks like. It's actually the remarkable piece is that we're boosting the patient's immune system to take over. There are actually immunotherapies already FDA approved, Keytruda, for example, Opdivo, for example, and these patients can access in their oncologist office all over the country and all over the world. But there are other immune therapies, T cell directed therapies that we are investigating at Sarah Cannon that are being investigated over around the world. And these are trying to boost immune systems and T cells in particular in new and novel ways.
So if I'm sitting at home and I am battling cancer, breast cancer or whatever it is, would this or should this give me hope?
Absolutely. There's lots to be hopeful for now in the world of T cell directed immunotherapies like described this morning. I think how these therapies work are that they start with the patient. We start with blood or tissue from the patient, take it out of the patient's bloodstream or out of the body in the form of a tumor biopsy. The T cells are filtered out, and then they're educated or taught to recognize particular aspects of their very own cancer. Then those T cells are infused back into the patient's body, and then they take over and go after the cancer.
It's remarkable. Dr. Melissa Johnson, thanks for being with us. We appreciate it.
Thanks for having me.